Hey guys, welcome to example program, and in this video we will see how we can write a simple Java program to check for even and odd number. In this video we will ask the user to enter a number, and then by applying some logic we will say whether the user has entered the even number or the odd number. Now, how we can say that a number is an even number or the odd number? If you have a number and when you divide this number by 2, if you get remainder 0, then this number is said to be even number. If this remainder is 1 or a non-zero value, then this number is said to be odd number. Now, for example, if I have the number 25 here, and what I have to do is I have to divide this number by 2 and I have to check for the remainder. Now here, when you divide this number 25 by 2, I get the remainder as 1. So this 25 is the odd number. And similarly, if you have the number 50, then I have to divide this number by 2. And this time we get the remainder as 0. So this 50 is the even number. Okay. Now we know how we can say that a number is an even number or the odd number. But how we can get the remainder when you divide a number by any other number? In Java programming language, we have an operator called as the modulus operator. And this modulus operator is denoted by this percentage symbol. When you use this operator, you get the remainder, and you will learn how to use this operator in this program. Now let's take a look at how we can write the Java program. Here I have written the skeleton of the program. I have created the package example program. This is a name that I have given to my package. And then we have imported the scanner class from util. And then we have created our class, and I have named it as even odd. And then we have the main function, which is the entry point of our program from our perspective. Now, here, first we will declare some of the variables that we need. The first variable that we need is for storing the user input. As I said in the beginning, we will be asking the user to enter a number, and then by looking at that number, we will display the appropriate message. So we need to take the input from the user and we have to store that somewhere. The variable will be of type integer, and I will name my variable as number. And then we need another variable for storing the remainder value which has been calculated, and I will name that variable as remainder. Okay. Now we have the couple of variables that we need. The next thing that we do is we will display a message asking the user to enter a number. And then we will read that input entered by the user, and we will store that in this number variable. So I will use this system.out.println method, and I will specify the message as please enter an integer number. Now by looking at this message, user will enter a number, and we have to read that user input. For that purpose, let's create an object of the scanner class which we have imported. So it will be scanner, and I will name my object as scan equal to new scanner, and here we need to pass in system.input, which is system.in. here we are passing the input stream. The next thing that we do is we will take the input from the user, and for that we will use a method available in this scanner class, and that method is called as the next int. So it will be scan dot next int. This will read an integer value and return that. We want to store that value in our number variable, so it will be number equal to scan dot next int. The next thing that we do is we will close the scanner object, because you know we have taken the input from the user and we don't need to use the scan object again. So scan dot close. Okay, now we have the input from the user, or the number that we want to check for even or odd. The next thing that we do is we will calculate the remainder when we divide the number by 2. So what we have to do is we have to divide the value stored in this number variable by 2, and then we need to get the remainder value. So here we will be using the modulus operator. When you perform number modulus 2, it will divide the value stored in this number variable by 2 and it will return the remainder value. So we will store that remainder value returned in this remainder variable. With this statement, we are getting the remainder value when we divide the number by 2. Now, by looking at this remainder value, we can say that whether the user has entered the even number or the odd number. So we will use a if statement and we will check the remainder value. If the remainder variable is containing the value 0, then it means that the number entered by the user is an even number. So we will display the message saying that. So it will be system.out.println, and here we will say number, and then I'm gonna append some text in here, and that will be is an even number. Okay, if the remainder variable is not containing a value of 0, then it means that the number entered by the user is an odd number. So we will display the message for that in this else part. Okay, I'm gonna change this one to odd number. Okay, now we have written the program and let's try to run this program. Please enter an integer number. I'm gonna enter 23 and it says 23 is an odd number. And that's true because, you know, when you divide this 23 by 2, you get the remainder as 1. Now let's run this again, and this time I'm gonna enter 50 and it says 50 is an even number. So here we can say that our program is working properly now. Now here you can simplify this code a lot. You can check for the even and odd number and you can display the result in just one line. Now if you shorten this code, then it will look something like this. Now here, you know, I have done all those things in just one line. You know, here I have used the ternary operator, you know, to simplify the things. Now, if you are a beginner, then you don't need to concentrate on, you know, writing this program like this. You can, you know, write the program like this. Okay. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, then hit the dislike button. If you want to say something, then write that in the comment box. For more videos like this, do subscribe to the channel. I'll see you later in the next video.